respecting, you know, the Christian church after he had successfully dealt with an army of peasants at Bergen. Many of the yeomen, the peasants, came to him and he gave quarter. He showed mercy to all who asked, and as he marched through the town, he kissed all the chief churches. So when raiding, Kingsbury was on a raid in this small fragment. When raiding, he refrains from setting fire to churches or robbing them, which was extremely important for that period of time. And because the saga was written by order of Kingsbury, some authors even think that this was just propaganda, that Kingsbury behaved just like his enemies, robbing the churches, taking all the gold, you know, and setting fire to them, because otherwise his enemies would have hidden themselves in the church. Because in the same saga, the enemy of Kingsbury, who was King Magnus, who also wanted to be king of Norway, he is portrayed doing that thing. For example, the other fragment shows what King Magnus did. Many took refuge in the churches, many of Kingsbury's men, and were all slain. No church was a safe refuge this time. Men were dragged out of Christkirk and slain, a deed that had never been done hitherto. One old Birkebeiner, the Birkebeiners were Kingsbury's faction, named Eivind Skrapit, a valiant warrior, tall and strong, was taken from the choir and dragged out of Christkirk. They placed him on a sledge, dragged him to the Eyra River and slew him there. So, in the saga, King Frederick is shown protecting churches, while his enemy King Magnus is shown defying and committing sacrilege in the church, killing men in the church. So, again, another example of how these practices of raiding continued in the sagas, and probably the fact that King Varys is shown so merciful and respectful to churches is possibly also just something like propaganda of the time. In chapter 42 of Konungs skuggsjá, it's copiously dedicated to the ideal of kingly behavior before God, who always loves justice and humility. In the beginning, the son is given the biblical example of patriarch Joseph, who was sold into slavery in Egypt, but was saved from imprisonment and made second in power next to the Pharaoh by God's love of him. So there are many stories of wisdom taken from the Old Testament and the Bible. And next, I want to compare these stories with what we know from Havamal, for example. Havamal are Odin's advice or words of wisdom, which are preserved in the Edda. What else is in common scripture? They give the story of Queen Vashti in the Book of Esther in such a way that the influence and haughtiness of the queen are highlighted. Furthermore, the son's instruction continues with the detail that the new queen Esther was able to persuade Queen Vashti to listen to her pleas only when she fell humbly at his feet and concludes that God demands moderation and fairness, humility, justice, and fidelity for the duty from those whom she raises to honor. This is reinforced with a
further example of a purported Christian Jewish dinner held by Emperor Constantine and his mother, Empress Helena, where both illustrious leaders conceded their right to judge in the synod to a lesser, more learned, to lesser, more learned and wiser men. The son is reminded in Konungs skuggsjá that God holds in his hand the tiller with which he turns and moves the hearts of great lords whenever he wishes, and controls order all their thoughts according to his will. And this implies that the power of God ought to be respected and feared by the king, who, though high as Emperor Constantine, must know his limits, as well as by his subjects, who, just like the example of Esther, may rise to a great and noble position owing to their humility and piety. So let's compare biblical wisdom with Havamal. The advice that Odin provides in the Edda. So all these verses are taken from the Havamal in the Edda, and Odin says he had need of his wit to wonder twice what sick or the servant home, but again in stock is the fool who sits with the wise and nothing knows. So the same.
An encouragement to become wise, to learn from other people. Let no man glory in the greatness of his mind, but rather keep watch over his wits. Cautious and silent let him enter a dwelling. To heedful comes seldom harm, for none can find a more faithful friend than the wealth of a mother wit. So again, even Odin advises humility, cautiousness, and he never advises haughtiness, or pride.